गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट. रिमेनिंग टॉपिक ऑफ द नर्वस सिस्टम आर सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स, इट्स फंक्शन, थैलेमस, बेसल गैंग्लिया एंड सेरेबेलम. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स एंड इट्स फंक्शन. सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स इट इज ए आउटर लेयर ऑफ न्यूरल टिश्यू ऑफ द सेरेब्रम ऑफ द ब्रेन. सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स मीन्स द आउटर लेयर ऑफ द न्यूरल टिश्यू ऑफ द सेरेब्रम ऑफ द ब्रेन. It is separated into two cortices by longitudinal fissure that divides the cerebrum into left and right cerebral hemisphere. Means this due to this longitudinal fissure, this cortex divided into two, left and right. Then these two join beneath by the corpus callosum. Corpus callosum is one of the structure of brain, and due to this cerebral hemisphere join beneath. And function of this cerebral cortex is divided into three parts: sensory, motor and the association. Then we will discuss one by one. Sensory, there are three areas in the cerebral cortex and that have different functions. Sensory area receive and process information from the senses such as touch, vision and hearing. What we see here and what we feel touch, this sensory area, this receive and process information. Then second is the motor areas located in both hemispheres related to control of all voluntary movements. Which voluntary movement are all involved in this motor area and associated with this motor area. And third is the association area. Association area produce meaningful perceptual experience of the world, support thinking and language. Due to this association area, we can convert it into language due to this association area. Then we will learn in detail about the cerebral cortex. Cerebral cortex is a outer layer of the neural tissue of the cerebrum. Outer layer of the neural tissue of the cerebrum of the brain in humans and other mammals also. Cerebral cortex separated into two cortices by the longitudinal fissure that divides the cerebrum into left and right cerebral hemisphere. The two hemispheres are joined together beneath the cortex by the corpus callosum. The cerebral cortex is the largest site of neural integration in the central nervous system. It plays a key role in attention, perception, awareness, thought, memory, language and consciousness. Then functions. In more general terms, the cortex is typically described as comprising three parts: sensory, motor and the association area. Sensory area are the cortical areas that receive and process information from the senses. Parts of the cortex that receive sensory inputs from the thalamus are called primary sensory areas. The senses of vision, hearing and touch are served by the primary visual cortex, primary auditory cortex and primary somatosensory cortex respectively. Then motor areas. The motor areas are located in both hemisphere of the cortex. The motor cortex, motor areas are very closely related to control of voluntary movement, especially fine fragment movements performed by the hand. The right half of the motor area control the left side of the body and vice versa. Motor areas, right side control left side and left side control right side. Then association areas. The association area are the parts of the cerebral cortex that do not belong to primary regions. They function to produce meaningful perceptual experience of the world, enable us to interact effectively and support abstract thinking and language. The parietal, temporal, and occipital lobes, all located in the posterior part of the cortex, integrate sensory information and information stored in the memory. Then we learn about the thalamus of the brain. Thalamus is a small structure within the brain, just above the brainstem, between the cerebral cortex and the midbrain, and it has extensive nerve connection to both. Main function is to relay motor and sensory signals to the cerebral cortex. We can see the diagram of the thalamus. Thalamus is a structure located within the brain, between the cerebral cortex and the midbrain. This is a thalamus. This is a structure of brain. This upper is the cerebral cortex. Then this is cerebellum. This is a thalamus. In below this thalamus, there is a hypothalamus, and this is the midbrain. Midbrain is part of the brain stem, pons, medulla, and this spinal cord. And this small structure is the thalamus. What is the main function? Is to relay motor and sensory signals to the cerebral cortex. We will see detail in the about the thalamus. Thalamus is a small structure within the brain, located just above the brain stem, between cerebral cortex and the midbrain. Function of the thalamus is the thalamus, or the dorsal and ventral thalamus, collectively are two oval structure made up of gray matter at the base of the cerebrum. This structure's primary function is a relay center through which sensory nerves transmit signal from the spinal cord and brainstem on the way to the cerebral cortex. Disorders include ataxia, pain syndrome, visual disorders, variety of neurophysiological condition, and coma. Main function is to collect information from the spinal cord, brainstem, and gives to the cerebral cortex. It is act as a relay center. Main function of the thalamus is the relay center. Then we will learn about the basal ganglia. In structure, we can see that this is a basal ganglia. This one. This is a cerebral cortex. This is a cerebellum. This is a basal ganglia and thalamus. In this structure, we can see separate structure of the basal ganglia. It contains caudate nucleus, lenticular nucleus, and amyloid. Basal ganglia means collection of nucleus or group of subcortical nuclei situated at the base of the forebrain, and function is to control of voluntary motor movement, eye movement. Basal ganglia's primary functions is likely to control areas so that voluntary movement can be performed smoothly. Here is the structure of the basal ganglia, means group of subcortical nuclei. We will see in detail about the basal ganglia. Basal ganglia are the group of nuclei situated below the at the base of the forebrain. The main component of the basal ganglia as defined functionally are the striatum. Striatum is the main function. Functioning area consisting of both dorsal striatum and the ventral striatum. The globus pallidus, the ventral pallidum, the substantia nigra, and the subthalamic nucleus are the part of the basal ganglia. Largest component of the striatum receives input from many brain areas beyond the basal ganglia. Receives inputs from many brain areas beyond the basal ganglia, but only send output to other components of the basal ganglia. And pallidum receives input from the striatum and send inhibitory output to a number of motor related areas. The substantia nigra is the source of striated input of the membrane neurotransmitter dopamine, which plays an important role in basal ganglia function. The subthalamic nucleus receives input mainly from the striatum and cerebral cortex and project to the globus pallidus. ग्लोबस पैलिडस इज ए पार्ट ऑफ दिस न्यूक्लियस, लेंटिकुलर न्यूक्लियस. पॉपुलर थियरीज इंप्लीकेट द बेसल गैंग्लिया प्राइमरी इन एक्शन सिलेक्शन इन हेल्पिंग टू डिसाइड विच ऑफ सेवरल पॉसिबल बिहेवियर टू एग्जीक्यूट एट एनी गिवन टाइम. इन मोर स्पेसिफिक टर्म्स द बेसल गैंग्लियाज प्राइमरी फंक्शन इज टू लाइकली टू कंट्रोल एंड रेगुलेट एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द मोटर एंड प्री मोटर कॉर्टिकल एरियाज सो दैट वॉलंटरी मूवमेंट कैन बी परफॉर्म स्मूथली.